What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Stellaris. We're playing as the Turtle Boys, who everybody knows. They're very famous. And let's see, we have one unemployed pop. That's the Fotisian that we saw earlier. Alright, first of all, we met the Fotisian League. And we have a trade deal going on where we both give each other migration access, I think it was called. And I think as a result of that, we got this migrant here, who apparently is repugnant. It's probably not very good. And basically what we could do is enslave him or purge him, but there isn't really anything for him to do right now. That's definitely an issue that we're facing. And we're also building a colony ship. That's going to be really good. We can finally get our colony started on Area Mun 3. And, okay, we can't actually do anything right now because we don't have enough minerals. That's good to know. We have some debris in Azha, or Ezha, however you want to pronounce it, you know, you do you. That's what I always say. So, we'll deal with that as soon as one of these science ships is available. They're both apparently surveying Erai. That almost sounded like a freaking remix. Era. That's good. Okay. So anyway, that's what we're dealing with here. I don't know what this guy's doing. Are they surveying the same planets or? I see this guy isn't doing anything. All right. Here's what we'll do. We're sending this science ship over to check out the debris here. That's gonna be good. And in the meantime, we'll just save up a bit of minerals. Although we really need to get more minerals, most of all, actually. We're not really getting that many. I mean, we've got a decent number, but it's not great. And then we should probably make some stations here as well. Oh, wait, we can't reach this yet, but we will eventually, I'm pretty sure. So we did meet the Fetician League. They are right here. Apparently, they already have 5 planets, whereas we only have 1. I believe that that's because we've met one. They're superior in basically every way. I think it's because that's one of the AI that at the start it said that they have better starts. This is probably one of them. That's what I'm gonna guess. I'm basing this on absolutely very little knowledge of the game. But I don't see any other way for someone to have 5 planets already. So we gotta make sure that they like us. If we get into a bit of a scrap here with these people, that's going to be very bad. They have 5 planets. They have double the population that we have. So it could be very bad. So we're basically going to do our best to make sure they remain our allies. And hopefully we can, you know, get something going there. Maybe work together a little bit. Let's just, at any cost or at any rate, let's try to avoid any conflict with these people. Because they will destroy me. And, okay, colony ship's almost ready. We're at 90% here. So the planet what we will be colonizing is Area Mun 3. Very excited about that. This will be our very first colony. I'm hoping it's going to be really good. It seems like there's actually some really good tiles here. Most of them appear to be quite workable. So it's looking beautiful. It's looking beautiful. Habitability, really good as well because it's a naturally beautiful planet. Let's see, it is a... What kind of planet is it? Show me. Tropical world. And I think that's what we are. Yeah, that's what we're used to. But because it's not our home planet, it's not entirely 100% habitable. Although I think you can improve that later, probably with some type of... Alright. Some type of technology or something like that. So here's the colony ship. We could actually make a colony on... several different systems, but this is definitely the best one available to us right now, so we will go ahead and colonize Area Mun 3. We're gonna place the colony. I have to consider this pretty carefully, seeing as where you place your initial, I guess, colony ship is going to determine what tiles around it get a bonus. So I think what I'm gonna do is just go with the tropical terrain there. And then we gotta get the necessary technology to clear out these jungles later. But at least this food tile is gonna be really good. The society research tile is gonna be great. I mean, I'm just very positive about this. All right, our fleet's upgraded. I'm just very positive about our future on this planet. I'm sure it's going to be great. Now, let's see. All we can really get, our only options basically, is slightly more energy or a bit more research. So I guess we'll try and get some engineering research by building a research. Oh, that's terrible. That is almost not worth it. All right, let's make a research station here. Oh, they're already doing it? Apparently so. I didn't even mean to do that. But I guess it worked out in the end. I have to be more careful about where I click. I could have done something really, really bad there. But we're okay. Then our fleet has... Alright, the frigate. We have an extra corvette on the way, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe two? Is it one or two? Alright, we have one corvette on the way. We could actually get another one after this. We gotta have 78 minerals. Or somewhere between 77 and 78, I guess. I don't really know. Base cost. I don't really know. Either way, we should get some more corvettes, though. We have a pretty decent fleet already. The turtle fleet. We got that frigate that we found earlier. Still super happy about finding that. I haven't seen an event like that in any of my other playtime. Which isn't super long, but still, I haven't seen something like this before. Okay, so we do want these. Let's see. They're both around Ubaria. So let's merge them. I want one big turtle fleet. And now they have the wrong name. Turtle fleet. Come on, am I going to have to do this every time now? That seems a little annoying, but okay. You'd think that the single ship being added to the other fleet would adopt the name of the bigger fleet, but apparently that just doesn't work. All right, colony ship is entering orbit of Ariamon 3. Look at this beautiful, beautiful colony ship. We're gonna be rich very soon. So good, okay. The first Zadrin colony. Our colony ship has found a rare patch of open ground in the jungles of Jorgsikrop and made planetfall. The landing site is surrounded on all sides by lush vegetation, and sentry drones have been deployed to guard against predators. The ship has been permanently converted into the administrative headquarters of the new settlement, and its reactor core is in the process of being removed so that it may serve as the colony's temporary power source. Hundreds of small tents and prefab shelters have sprung up. Colonists begin to disembark in large numbers. So this is actually it. We now have a colony. Oh, they're currently colonizing. Which will take a while. In fact, it'll take a little bit over a year. And here we can actually see the reassembled ship shelter now. Which I believe eventually we have to upgrade to an actual administration building. But for now, look at that. Look at that beautiful... new part of space that belongs to me now. So what I think we should do, we're currently checking this out. We saw some alien vessels here. Though I don't recall how strong they were. Let's go and check out the Tripalum system. Apparently we didn't finish that earlier. And seeing as it will be right next to our, well, pretty close to our new colony, we should probably just check it out. Make sure it looks good. 6 months remaining. All right, so then we can actually get a mineral processing plant. That's going to be really cool. We're also still working on those mining drone lasers. I'm hoping those are going to be cool. Because I have no idea. And then the border range going up. Again, I don't know what exactly that does. I'm guessing it's going to expand our borders and make sure that other empires can't get too close to our planets and colonies and such. I don't really know if that's how it works, but that's what I'm assuming. And okay, we are gonna need at least one more corvette, although I would like to see, I think, two more before we really try and fight some people. All right, at least we have some more construction options right now. That's good. And I guess we're just gonna wait for Ariamon to keep going. It's just called Jorgsikrop. I mean, it's kind of a stupid name though. I'm gonna give a fitting name. Shell Planet. That's better. And that way I don't have to pronounce this weird ass name every single time I want to talk about my new colony. Shell Planet, and well, Obaria is actually kind of a cool name, so I'll keep that. Sometimes you got to respect your history. And maybe this is one of those times. Where are you going? All right, surveying the Tripalum system. We've got the Leviathans over there. All right, we've seen everything in the array system. So that's good. And now it's time that we started exploring a bit more. I think I want to see... We still haven't apparently explored all of Marfark yet. Let's just do that. Let's get that over with. Yeah, why not? Let's survey this and slowly start making our way towards the Marfark system, and that way we can expand our map a bit and figure out what's all around us, because we have no idea, honestly. But we gotta get more minerals somehow. Yeah, we don't have too many options, really. Well, that's a bummer. I don't know what to do about that. I guess all I can really normally do is just make more... Wait, we still haven't explored the Caspidian system? We've really got to do that as well. Alright, so we have an extra Corvette now. We also have an extra research station. And it looks like the Mon Akadir system is actually going to be in our borders quite soon. So that should be nice, but we need more... energy credits. So what we really need... Alright, so they're almost done with the array system. Tripalum. Alright, so you check out the Tripalum system, because apparently we're not done there. This guy, check out the Marfark system instantly, because we can actually work this. And we obviously do want to see if there's anything of value there, because we have no idea. In the meantime, we can actually make a... Oh, we don't have the money for this, or the minerals. But we probably do want to make a mining station on ISM 4 or 6. And get some extra, not minerals, energy credits there, because we're starting to run out. Oh boy. Alright, so there's some crystalline entities in Siluria. Meaning that we can't actually go from there, but at least now we know there are enemies there to fight. They're not super tough. If we can fight them one-on-one, we should be able to win. I guess we'll see. But I'm pretty sure that once the colony here is done, we're not going to be spending a lot of money on this stuff anymore. And every turn, apparently, that it grows, it will expend the rest of our empire. Because we are really, really close to Mon Akadir. Which I am very much looking forward to, because that's a lot of energy that we can actually get there. I mean, 7 energy, that's quite good. Alright, so what you need to do... There we go, that's better. That's what I was looking for. And then we saw, alright, alien vessels there. Still have to kill Space Amoeba. We have to survey a whole lot more. Let me just see if my... Alright, so the relation with the Fetishian League is going pretty well. They still have a lot more population than I do. They're 29. Which is insane, because weren't they at 25, like, 10 minutes ago? At least we know that their fleet's actually pretty weak. They seem to just have better technology and, I guess, a lot more planets, but... At least I know that maybe if we do go to war eventually, we might still stand a chance. I guess it's not as bad as I had assumed it was. Alright, come on, we're almost here. Almost, look at this. We just really need our colony to expand a bit more. It's gonna take so about half a year and then it'll be done. And we should be seeing a lot more energy by then anyway. But I also want to see, alright, here we go, almost there. I also really want to see more territory where we can work things. Darrakis, that's also a really cool name. Alright, so research complete. We can now make mineral processing plants, which are pretty expensive, but really good. And here's our new options. We've got coil guns. More powerful version of the early mass drivers. Sounds pretty good. Defense platform. Defensive deep space platforms far from the gravity wells of a planetary body. I don't know how good those really are. Deep space outposts. And then there's powered exoskeletons, which will give us extra army damage and extra minerals. It's just a flat bonus. I'm gonna go with that one. That one's amazing. I'm sorry, but I need this in my life. And then... Alright, so I think we were... Wait, were we not making a... Oh, we wanted to make a mining station here. That's 90... minerals. I mean, there's no actual option to get more minerals right now. So I guess all we can really do is just build that station then and just prepare for the future. Even though we're already in the future, but you know. Gotta get some more energy. I'm just excited to see how big our borders are going to be once we actually finish Shell Planet. And I want to see how fast it grows. I want to see everything about it. I'm excited. I like colonies in video games. They're cool. And they're definitely, I think, better than actual real life. Actually colonizing stuff in real life. I mean, it's probably better if you just do it in a video game. So... I feel like I was trying to make a point there, and I don't know what it really was, but just ignore it. Oh my god, we're really close now. Come on, colony. I feel like when it's done, we are going to be able to reach this. I mean, we're even starting to get close to the Dirac system. There's nothing else really on our borders. Alright, we actually, for people that only have two planets, our territory is looking pretty okay. I feel like the Fetisian League should have a lot more territory, but I don't know, maybe they're just being bad or something. Look how close it is. Just give it to me. Okay, I also wouldn't mind being able to work that, but that's probably not going to happen anytime soon. We also, if we want to get another frontier outpost, we are going to need a lot more influence though. And I already figured out that there's at least, as far as I know, there's at least two ways to get more influence. One is to get certain research done. And another one would be, oh my god, come on. Another one would be to declare some other AI your rival. Which is bad for your relationship, but you do get more influence. And that's pretty cool. They don't like my purge policy, but they're pacifists, and I think we're military more, well, we're collectivists. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what it is that they don't like. Edict duration and cost is up, or cost is actually down. Policies, oh my, what? Hold up. I said, hold up. War economy is static. There's no voting rights. This is pretty cool. I didn't even know this existed. Alright, so most of our pop are Zadran. We have a bit of extra happiness, bit of extra food. We can't release someone as a vassal, but these policies, I didn't know about these. That's actually really cool. So you can actually prioritize certain things that you think are appropriate. I mean, I won't do any of this now, obviously. Orbital bombardment. Purge allowed. So we could change our policy and say, okay, we're going to prohibit purging. We will not be able to change our stance on this for 10 years. Alright, let's give this a go. So I think that should make these guys actually like me a lot better, because I'm very much against purging now, so they like me better. That's really cool to know. See, that's something I just randomly found out. Slave procreation. We can decide if slaves should be allowed to procreate or not. Slavery is allowed. War economy. Alright, I'm not going to mess with this. Migration. is free, primary species only, nah. Orbital bombardment, voting rights, leadership. So we could actually, oh, we can't get voting going there. First contact protocol, so you can say that we're gonna be peaceful or aggressive. That's cool. All right, we might have to dig into that a little bit later. See if we need to change anything, but for now, I just want to see my colony. If we just could do that, because that would be cool. Oh, we're, oh, come on. They're just messing with me now. We're actually getting closer to Milistamu than Mauna Kadir. We stumbled upon a faint alien signal during the survey of this moon. The source appears to be a small object in orbit. The signal contains no message. All right, well, check it out. I don't really care. I mean, that's fine with me. Although, maybe... yeah, this is pretty slow. Well, that's alright. I actually really wanted to check out Marfark first, maybe, but I guess we're okay. Alright, so we checked out Tripalum. Let's check out Opang then. Might want to see if there's anything good there. We've established the colony Shell Planet. It is now ready to go, and we don't quite... oh, come on, we're so close to several systems here, but not quite there. But here we go, it's a natural, beautiful planet. Although this tile isn't the best, and apparently... oh, right, we did send that Fetisian there. And his habitability is actually a lot higher than my own species would be. So they should be growing a bit quicker than they normally would. And I think that's cool. Alright, can't upgrade this. As much as I'd like to, we can't do that because we require at least 5 pops and a lot more minerals, but okay. At least we know that eventually... right now we're not getting anything from this planet. It's not... actually costing me anything anymore, but it's just slowly growing. So what we need is to start working these types of tiles, and that way we do get some minerals, we get energy, science, all kinds of things. So at the start, okay, what are void cloud? Probably shouldn't mess with that right now. I feel like that thing would destroy me, and I don't think I want to really send in the army quite yet. Yeah, we're basically out of options to really do anything. We can get some research going here and there. But we might need a frontier outpost to really get anywhere else. And we just don't have the... oh, the influence to do that. Abandoned life pod was detected in closed orbit of Marfark 6A. Scorch marks, okay, mothership exploded. So we get 60 society research, which is pretty cool. I think we already read this one. Plus 50. Okay, they're starting to like me. We're now cordial. They're slightly superior to me. Hey, you guys want to make a deal? Alright, they're not quite interested in an alliance quite yet, but we are starting to get pretty close there, which is cool. Oh, they actually have the Fetisian, Betharian stone. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Alright, so listen, border access. Detailed charts of all explored space. Full map vision. Alright, so we should probably go with star charts first. And I guess I'd be willing to trade mine as well. But you're gonna have to pay me. Minerals. Let's see how many they're willing to give. Oh, here we go. They're willing to give me 29 minerals, I guess. Let's see if they accept this deal. Okay, they did not like that. Okay, so listen. It's okay. We can take the minerals off the table. Let's just trade star charts. There's no reason not to do this. You know, we trust each other. Okay, well, they're not super friendly about, you know, declining the offer. God. All right, mining station's done. Yeah, we don't have a lot of options right now, so I guess we'll just make a research station on Eriamun. And we're just going to deal with that. Eriamun 2. Okay, Science Officer Rohab has leveled up and gained the trait Spark of Genius. This is one I was talking about earlier. This actually gives him plus 10 research speed on every type of technology available. So what we might want to do is switch him out with, let's see, someone like, I guess Rema, maybe. What did I just do? Yes, and then switch him in there. Rohab. Go. And now we should be seeing slightly better research. I don't know if it's like important enough to like micromanage all this stuff, but it seemed like it was worth it, so I just did it. It's gonna be good. All right. So we still don't really have anything to work. That's the only real bummer here. But we are getting close. So I think eventually we'll get here. I'm not sure how long it's going to take, but I think we can do it. But anyway, guys, I'm going to leave it here for now. I hope you guys enjoyed. And I'm going to be back soon with more Stellaris, where we can hopefully get more minerals, most of all, and possibly expand our borders somehow. I don't really know what to do. But we'll figure it out. Anyway, you guys, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.